Tuesday night.
We will march in full uniform on the streets of Skokie on Independence Day.
In 1977, the American Nazi Party plunged a quiet Chicago suburb into chaos.
Everybody knows it's a damn joke.
And forced a Holocaust survivor to face a historic enemy with an uncontrollable rage that threatened even the family he loved.
If they bring the swastika here, there is nothing will keep me from fighting.
Danny Kaye heads an award-winning cast in Skokie, an American event, Tuesday.
Sunday on Alice, when Mel's cousin shows up, Mel gives him a crash course in how to woo a woman. Then on the Jeffersons, George is stuck with two maids and has to fire one.
Where's your backbone? Don't they make them in your size?
On Trapper John, will a new program using relatives to help care for patients backfire? It's all happening Sunday, starting at 9, 8 Central and Mountain.
Tomorrow on CBS.
The space shuttle Columbia is home again tonight. The smiling astronauts, Joe Engle and Dick Truly, stepped out of their cabin today and into the history books.
Governor Thompson has accepted a debate challenge from Adlai Stevenson, and tonight I'll have the conclusion of a special report on child care. Our working parents are working it out.
All that and more next on the Channel 2 Weekend News at 10.
Some people just can't believe they could ever win $1 million playing instant lottery. And you know what? They never will. Other people know that anybody can win $1 million. And you know what? They're absolutely right.
It was worth $1 million to me.
7-Eleven 21 Instant Lottery. It's easy to play. It only costs a buck. And you know what? It could be worth $1 million to you, too.
Seafood platter. Crisp fish. Big shrimp. Scallops.
Bring it on, Long John.
Fries. Crunchy hush puppies. Fresh coleslaw.
Long John Silver's Seafood Platter.
Right now at a special price. Bring it on, Long John.
You going to do anything today?
No, weekends are for resting.
It's the perfect time to call your brother.
You're right. Hey, Eddie.
Eddie's in San Diego.
Weekends are for being silly, too.
Right now, a 20-minute visit as far away as San Diego costs only $3.67.
Hey, Eddie.
Dial direct anytime Saturday till 5 p.m. Sunday and save more than half the full weekday rate.
I've grown a full beard.
Oh, Eddie, don't.
WBBM-TV, Channel 2, Chicago.
It was a mission plagued by problems. But in the end, the space shuttle Columbia landed without a hitch. The first time a manned spacecraft has ever returned to Earth a second time.
Three, touchdown.
Mike Parker, Susan Anderson, Roger Field, and John Drummer. With the Channel 2 Weekend News.
Good evening. Astronauts Joe Engle and Richard Truly are heading back to Houston tonight. Their two-day mission aboard the space shuttle Columbia is over. It ended this afternoon in spectacular fashion, as Terry Drinkwater reports.
As the Columbia came down a dot over California, the weather was a mix of good and bad, like the mission itself. Some clouds, some blue skies. But the spacecraft functioned perfectly.
Good, solid bird all the way.
The shuttle's descent was steeper this time, 10,000 feet per minute, the ride bumpier, 90-mile-an-hour winds at this altitude. Among those who came to see it all with their own eyes, you could feel the tension, the concern. The sonic boom. On the final turn, a minute from touchdown, the Columbia was traveling at 330 miles an hour. At this point, the pilots were hands-on, flying the shuttle towards runway number 23. Split-second microwave scans back and forth from the ground told the onboard computer precisely where the Columbia was and how high. Then, seconds later, touchdown, or flare-out, as the pilots called it.
Welcome home. Thank you, Chase.
The shuttle weighs 100 tons. This feat of technology and men brought tens of thousands to the Mojave Desert to watch. Just think, it's marvelous. I can't believe it. Wow. Space fans were ecstatic. NASA and the astronauts were sounding almost as if the event was routine. To cool the shuttle down after its hot re-entry, some support vehicles sucked out warm air and pumped in cold. Others were to vacuum out toxic, even potentially explosive gases.
Crew is coming out of the
Engle and Truly had, of course, planned to be getting out of their spacecraft 3 days from now, had the mission gone its full length. But at least their landing was virtually flawless, and they were happy men indeed. From here, the astronauts returned by jet to Houston, and the shuttle ultimately to the Cape for its third trip to space and back. Harry Drinkwater, CBS News, Edwards Air Force Base, California.
Military exercises involving the United States and four other nations are underway tonight in the Egyptian desert. The project is called Operation Brightstar, and it kicked off today with a colorful display of U.S. military strength. 24 transport planes dropped more than 850 paratroopers into the desert. The planes also dropped ammunition and armored trucks. The opening exercise was marred by injuries to four paratroopers, but officials say the injuries are not serious. The war games will last 2 weeks and will be the biggest test so far of America's rapid deployment force. In Northern Ireland tonight, officials are blaming the IRA for the assassination of a Protestant member of the British Parliament. Four gunmen wearing Halloween masks gunned down Reverend Robert Bradford as he met with his constituents in South Belfast. Bradford is the first member of Parliament to be murdered in the 12 years of violence in Northern Ireland. His caretaker was also killed as the terrorists made their escape. In London, the British Attorney General narrowly escaped death when a bomb exploded in his home. Sir Michael Havers and his wife were in Spain at the time of the blast. Havers has prosecuted several IRA terrorists and has been on an IRA hit list for 10 years.
In state politics tonight, we have a challenge and a response. Adlai Stevenson, the likely Democratic contender for the post, is calling for a one-on-one debate. And Governor Thompson told Channel 2 News tonight he will debate Stevenson, in his words, anytime, any place. And our exclusive Channel 2 News Chicago Sun-Times news poll tonight shows the two men nearly even. Among some 500 voters polled, Governor Thompson got a 48% favorable rating, Stevenson a 52% positive vote. That boils down to a close race between the two at this stage of the game, given our margin for error in this poll. It's plus or minus 4.5%. Our news poll also asked voters to rate Governor Thompson's performance in office. A respectable 54% say they approve of the job Thompson is doing. 33% say they disapprove, 14% have no opinion. Sunday's editions of the Chicago Sun-Times will have more about news poll conducted for us by Market Shares Corporation. Susan?
Mike, Governor Thompson tonight is enjoying enormous popularity at Navy Pier, where he is attending an unusual class reunion. Carol Krause has the story.
It was just after World War II that Navy Pier opened its doors to GIs coming home from battle. It became a University of Illinois campus, and from 1946 to 1965, 100,000 students went to classes here, held dances, became athletes. 20 years later, those memories are coming alive again. Tonight, 1,400 people have gathered in Navy Pier to celebrate the good old days at college here. But this reunion was not like most reunions, because the campus at Navy Pier was really not like other college campuses.
The waves used to really hit against the breakers on the side there, and you're writing an exam, your final exam, and all of a sudden it starts dripping down on you.
The long walks and the runs between a class on this end and a class on the other end, that's what I remember most.
Most of us worked our way through school. We're urban students, and we worked and we went to school, and we didn't have time for anything else. Well, we snuck in a few.
We had a fraternity called Row Dam and Row that my friend Jack Trucks initiated, and a sorority called Delta Rho Deal.
Tonight, the Navy Pier Alumni Association honored its first inductees to the Navy Pier Hall of Fame. Famous alums like John Chancellor and Ramsey Lewis, who did not attend tonight, and a familiar face who did attend.
And I was a member of the Student Senate. See, I do have legislative experience.
Carol Krause, Channel 2 News at Navy Pier.
Coming up, Susan will wrap up her special report on child care, and we will tell you about confusion at O'Hare Airport over a promotional gimmick staged by a fledgling airline.
Thousands of the most wanted holiday items are on sale now.
At all 17 Mays, Bell Scott, and Community Family Shopping Centers.
From brand name Echo, kitchen helpers at just 79 cents.
Choose a can opener, special knives and spoons, a pizza cutter, and much more.
$16.99 buys this beautiful 45-piece melamine dinnerware set.
You can use your Visa or MasterCard.
At Mays, Bell Scott, and Community Family Centers.
Holiday discount shopping, the way it should be.
Maybe you never noticed, but Homemakers doesn't have furniture sales. The reason is we can't. Our everyday prices are so low, we simply can't reduce them. But check for yourself. Check Homemakers prices against special sale prices at any other store and see if our everyday prices aren't as low or lower. And remember, it's not low-price furniture. It's good furniture at low prices. Every day. Homemakers. Woodfield, Downers Grove, and Orland Square.
Since 1928, Progresso Foods have been a tradition among people who really know Italian food. Italian.
Joe, have I got something special for you?
Now you can share in this tradition with our delicious minestrone and hearty lentil soups and Progresso's specially seasoned breadcrumbs that turn a meal into an Italian feast. And sauces, tomatoes, beans, all authentic Italian. So for real Italian food, make it Progresso or make it yourself.
Ah, Mrs. Mondaro, try my white clam sauce. You couldn't make it better yourself.
Oh, Tony.
American Airlines thinks a business traveler has no business waiting in line. After line, after line. That's why American gives you only one check-in line where you can get boarding passes for your entire trip instead of extra lines. Even pre-reserved seating up to 11 months in advance instead of waiting in more lines. So what are you waiting for?
We're American Airlines, doing what we do.
There is word tonight of a dramatic change in American family life. The Labor Department reports that more than half of the nation's children under the age of 18 have mothers who work away from home. Based on census figures from March of this year, a full 54% of all children have working moms. 10 years ago, only about 39% of the children had mothers who held down jobs. Most dramatic increase in employment occurred among mothers of preschool children under the age of 6.
Those figures, Mike, are a strong sign that it's not always mom who's minding the kids. A good example involves a family you're about to meet in this final report of our series on child care. The man of the house left the ministry more than 1 year ago.
Bruce and Linda Keekstra have been married 15 years and have 4 children. They're an unusual couple because they take turns being full-time parents.
We made a decision when we started having children that if possible, one of us would always try to be in the home during the formative years.
Right now, Linda teaches grade school and Bruce stays at home. This arrangement is second nature to the Keekstras, but they often encounter people who question Bruce's role as homemaker.
I think they are the people who separate mothering, you know, from parenting, and they think that only a mother can nurture a child in a certain way, and we have never felt we don't think that that is true at all.
I don't think a lot of husbands realize what goes on day to day in the house and the work that it entails and the frustration that derives from it. And they kind of pass it off as, she's just taking care of the kids. I know what it's like.
When it gets rough, two-parent families have each other to fall back on, but single parents have only themselves. In the past 10 years, the number of children living with just one parent has shot up a third. The Census Bureau now reports that 1 in 5 children lives in a single-parent family.
I guess I was destined to be your housewife with the car in the garage and your 2.3 children. And everything was fine, and I was pregnant, and my husband passed away.
24-year-old Holly Pacini has found a way to work and keep her son Denny with her. She runs a small catering business called Bagels on the Run. She takes orders over the phone, packages the food, then makes deliveries. All the while, Denny is with her. Ideally, parents would like their children to remain at home, but this is not always possible. One solution is a place that duplicates the child's own home environment, like this daycare home on Chicago's North Side.
Push it in there. You did it! You did it! That's great!
Madeline Wengler turned her apartment into a daycare home when she got divorced. She wanted to stay home to take care of her daughter, but she had to earn a living, too. Wengler charges up to $90 a week for infant care. In Cook County alone, there are over 1,300 daycare homes. Every time a new home opens up, it gets filled immediately.
It's unbelievable how many parents are out there begging for daycare. Not just daycare centers, either any kind of daycare. There just isn't, especially for babies. And the law limits us on the number of under two-year-olds that we can have. And it's sad that there isn't better daycare facilities out there for kids.
A good daycare home is more than a babysitting service. Daycare workers provide the children with a variety of activities, which are both fun and educational. Yet no matter how good the care or what decisions parents make, there are always some anxious moments. As a parent herself, Wengler explains those feelings.
Protection, love, am I doing the right thing? I have to do this, but is this the right thing to do? Should I maybe stay home and not make any money and starve until my kid has to go to school? It's hard. It's a hard decision to make. But they make it.
But very few options for parents exist, yet the need for child care is rapidly increasing. That's bringing about child care for profit, and many are concerned about that. We'll be keeping an eye on child care availability, and next week we'll tell you how to find good quality care.
Mild fall Sunday is ahead. Roger Field will have the forecast when we come back. And later, John Drummond with all the sports action, including Michigan's romp over Purdue.
Home fires can get a good start before smoke reaches the smoke detector upstairs. Fire prevention experts agree one just isn't enough. First Alert, America's leading producer of smoke detectors, recommends this plan. One smoke detector on the basement ceiling, another on the main floor, and a third upstairs. Your escape route should have the First Alert with escape light. The First Alert plan. The earlier the warning, the more time to escape.
Available at True Value Hardware stores.
When you want something a little more satisfying than wine, have Drysack on the rocks. It's what a lot of wine drinkers drink when they want a little more than white wine.
Imported by Judas Wild Sons.
Wrinkles, I hate them. The kind you get from Static Cling looks awful, doesn't it? Thank goodness Static Guard helps me look my best. Just spray, and seconds later, those clingy wrinkles are gone. It's fabulous. Static Guard works safely on slips, pantyhose, sweaters, everything.
Great, look.
Don't let Static put a wrinkle in your good looks. Get Static Guard, because nobody looks good in Static Cling.
Barbra Streisand, James Taylor, Barry Manilow, Fleetwood Mac, Billy Joel, Radar Weather, Johnny Mathis, Anne Murray, Concise News, Neil Diamond, The Beatles, Clear Traffic Watch, Chuck Mangione, Chicago. Move it easy with clear, continuous music on WCLR 102 FM.
A new airline's promotional gimmick offering flights to California for $4.05 is causing some confusion out at O'Hare tonight. Some 500 people are camped out hoping to buy those bargain tickets for Jet America's inaugural flights next week, but it looks as if some were misled. Those rates are for standby seats on flights leaving Monday, Tuesday, or Wednesday, not just Monday as had been announced. 405 lucky travelers, however, will get those cheap trips.
Roger has been strutting around like a peacock over in that weather corner because he's got some very good news.
I also beat Mike at Wadball. He's the king of the newsroom, and I beat him. But we do have some good news. Two beautiful days coming up, a little cloudy but nice and warm in the 60s. With all the bad weather out west, then we can sit here in Chicago and say, thank God we don't live in Seattle. Let me show you. The news is in Seattle. A fierce storm is up here in the northwest part of the country, churning a tremendous amount of bad weather around, with snow actually in Wyoming and Idaho, along with severe rains and some terrific rains in the northwest in Washington and Oregon. 25 to 30 foot waves in the Pacific along the coasts of those two states. So that's stuff you don't fool around with. We seem to be protected from that by some cloud cover that's extensive but light enough not to cause any rain, except for a few sprinkles in the Dakotas at the moment. We are clear in Chicago, and the rest of the country is warm. Take a look at the satellite photograph, and you'll see that Illinois is indeed in the clear, except for the central western part of the state right here. These clouds will move in tonight, no rain associated with them, and the bad weather is right here, as you can see, the view from 22,000 miles up in space. The temperatures in the suburbs, however, are falling, but not falling terrifyingly. In the 30s and 40s, down from the 50s and 60s earlier today, 38 in Hobart, Indiana, Berwyn 43, Des Plaines 39, Aurora 37. The winds are pumping light air up from the south, warm, moist air, but nothing that's going to give us rain here in this part of the country. Okay, the temperatures in Chicago right now are very nice. They've fallen to 37 at O'Hare, 45 at the lakefront, and 45 at Midway, but they're not falling terribly low. High for today is 61 at 3 in the afternoon, the low 27 at 7 this morning. The barometric pressure is the one to keep your eye on, 30.07, and very steady at this hour, indicating that there is no low front moving in our direct toward us. Sun rises at 6:39 in the morning. Okay, tonight, we are in for a chilly period while you sleep, in the 30s for most of you, even colder in the high 20s north of the city and away from the lake. Tomorrow, we bounce back for another nice day, a walk in a sweater or some puttering around the house. We should reach 60 degrees or pretty close to 60 with some clouds, but lots of sun. Monday, another day that calls for little more than a light sweater. Can you believe that? 62 degrees in Chicago in the middle of November. And after these two nice days right here, which are mostly sunny, we go into a cloudy period. We go into a period that has temperatures in the 50s rather than the 60s, but still, this is mid-November, and this is Chicago. This is beautiful weather for this time of year, one of the nicest falls we've had.
Roger, absolutely. You didn't beat me at wadball. We tied at wadball, and for those who are wondering what wadball is, you wad up paper balls and throw them into garbage cans as basketball hoops. A great way to spend a Saturday night, isn't it, Roger?
That's true, and for the most of the game, I had the bigger basket, so probably yeah. You had a disadvantage.
And we women do not partake in wadball.
That's true.
You're permitted.
Exclusively a male sport. And speaking of sports, next, we have the Bulldog with high school and Big Ten football.
In the lovely vacation fun land of Aspen, Colorado, Lois Butterball found true anxiety. It was her job to help Aspen prepare for the special breed of dedicated skiers who flock there every winter.
Snow shovels, the first major snow of the year is headed our way.
Everything had to be in perfect readiness. Every single city service and department had to function flawlessly, or the winter fun seekers would seek fun elsewhere. So to help manage the vital functions of the entire city, Lois Butterball chose a computer company. Her choice? Data General. For the same reasons that 77 of America's 100 largest companies have chosen Data General. Advanced technology with support to match.
Lois!
And service as reliable as the return of the snows to Aspen. Which is worth remembering the next time you trust your future to a computer company. Data General, the company that engineered the anxiety out of computers.
50 years ago in Germany, Audi was already building front-wheel drive cars. Today, front-wheel drive perfection is built into every 1982 Audi, including the new 5000 Turbo, the new 4000 Sports Sedan, and the new Audi Coupe. Audi brings innovative ideas from the old world to the new world. Audi, the art of engineering.
You know who that is, don't you? It's him, Old Man Winter with all those high fuel bills. But don't panic. The Beat Old Man Winter sale is on. Just pick up more Owens Corning fiberglass insulation today. Uh-oh. Remember, pink Owens Corning is on sale now.
Now here is all that promised football action with John Drummond.
And you're going to get it because Michigan tonight has the inside track for the Rose Bowl. If the Wolverines beat Ohio State next Saturday, it means that Michigan will represent the Big Ten in Pasadena on New Year's Day. The Hawkeyes kept their faint championship hopes alive by knocking Wisconsin out of title contention. Illinois remained unbeaten at home by beating the Hoosiers. And Michigan is smelling the roses as the Wolverines beat Purdue. At Camp Randall Stadium, the visiting Iowa Hawkeyes leading 3-0 in the second quarter. Gordy Bohannon hits Dave Moritz with the 57-yard pass that puts the ball on the Badgers' 3-yard line. Two plays later, Phil Blatcher bulls over from the one to make it 10-0 Hawkeyes. Later in the quarter, Blatcher took it in from the two, and the game was out of reach. The Badgers got a consolation TD in the last quarter, but Iowa wins, much to the delight of the faithful Hawkeye fans. At Ross-Ade Stadium, Michigan took a 7-3 halftime lead on a 27-yard pass from quarterback Steve Smith to tight end Craig Dunaway. But midway through the third quarter, Purdue's Jeff Fuhlner, making his first collegiate start, went 5 yards to put the Boilermakers up 10-7. The Wolverines went ahead to stay in a 29-yard ramble by Mr. Smith as Michigan wins to take over sole possession of first place in the Big Ten Conference. In other Big Ten games, Ohio State handed Northwestern its 30th straight loss. There's a slim chance that Ohio State could still win the conference. Michigan State outscored Minnesota. They call that, folks, basketball with shoulder pads. And out Rocky Mountain way, Notre Dame shot down the Air Force. Tailback Phil Carter, who you see on the videotape, scored 2 touchdowns, rushed for 156 yards in that Irish victory. Carter's TD runs were for 4 yards and 1 yard. As Notre Dame boosted its season mark to 5-4, the win kept Notre Dame's bowl hopes alive. In games involving the top 10, Pittsburgh and Clemson easy winners, but get this, in Seattle, Washington's Huskies upset the Trojans. Georgia apparently heading for a Sugar Bowl berth beat Auburn. Alabama walloped Penn State, and Orange Bowl-bound Nebraska had an easy time with Iowa State. Bama coach Bear Bryant racked up his 314th coaching victory to tie the college record held previously by Amos Alonzo Stagg. Quarterback Walt Lewis's 2 touchdown passes paced the Crimson Tide. A record crowd of 85,000 jammed Beaver Stadium, but slightly favored Penn State never could get untracked. Alabama sewed up the win in the first half, led 24-3 at intermission as the Crimson Tide downs the Nittany Lions 31-16. In other games involving the top 10, SMU and UCLA and Texas were all winners this afternoon. Elsewhere, Arkansas squeaker over the Texas Aggies, and Missouri, in a nice surprise, upset the Oklahoma Sooners 19-14. And closer to home, Miami beat Northern Illinois in a Mid-America Conference game, and in two Missouri Valley Conference battles, Drake won and Southern Illinois beat New Mexico State. Well, the Bulls, talking now to basketball, routed the Washington Bullets, you'll remember, in a preseason game, but when it counted tonight in a league contest, it was Washington 104 and Chicago 99. Second quarter action, Landover, Maryland. That's John Lucas of the white-clad Washington Bullets driving and scoring with an underhand layup. That made it 29-28 Bullets. But with 1 second left, Artis Gilmore hits a 40-footer to make it 49-48 Bulls at the half. Gilmore had 24 points for the night. The Bullets carried a slim 77-73 lead in the final quarter. That was Rick Mahorn on the turnaround jumper. And then rookie Jeff Ruland went to work. He poured in 9 points in a fourth quarter spree as Washington wins 104-99. In hockey, the Red Wings, this at Joe Louis Arena, beat the Blackhawks 6-3 tonight in a game in the Motor City. A couple of Catholic League powerhouses scored victories this afternoon in state high school football action. In 6A play, those are the big schools, Fenwick upset previously unbeaten Nutrier, and Brother Rice beat Julian. Elsewhere, another 6A action, Revis shut out Naperville, and East Moline a big winner over Homewood Flossmore. And now in those in the 5A quarterfinals, Deerfield beat Rockford Guilford, Elk Grove Village won, and Joliet Catholic, the team that a lot of people says is the best prep squad in the state, too strong for Hinsdale South. In the 4A quarterfinals, Wheaton North beat DeKalb, and Bennett beat Rich South 24-0. In the girls' high school volleyball tournament in Springfield, the Immaculate Conception Spikers won the Class A championship, beating Mendota, and tonight, Mother Macaulay, a powerhouse, won the Class AA finals over Sandburg. And in soccer, the state high school tournament finals tonight at Palatine, Collinsville beat Glenbrook North by a score of 2-1. And by the way, Susan and her husband will not be singing the Whip and Poof song tonight because Yale got beat by Princeton 35-31. The Bears tomorrow at noon on Channel 2. Johnny Morris, Mike Sy.
Talk about my alma mater.
Illinois. I'm aware of that. Pride and Joy Rochelle went to Illinois.
Bears go against Green Bay tomorrow,
right?
That's right. Who you picking?
12 noon. I think the Bears are going to win. Yeah. How's that?
Is there a sportscaster in Chicago who doesn't predict the Bears are going to win?
That's like the sun is going to rise.
Yeah.
Tomorrow. Okay. Thanks, John.
Thank you, John. That's our news for tonight. Thank you for being with us. Good night.
Good night.
Stretch beautifully. Stretch comfortably. Stretch denim by Gloria Vanderbilt for Merjani.
Now at Marshall Fields.
Car
Arby's rings in the holiday season. Come in and look at the world through Courier and I's glasses only at Arby's. Just buy a medium-sized soft drink and get a beautiful Courier and I's glass for 49 cents. We've captured and preserved forever winter in America in the Courier and I's glass collection. Collect all four and relive America's joyous past when you take them home. Because memories are made of glass at Arby's.
America's roast beef, yes sir.
Collect all four Courier and I's glasses only at Arby's.
The most famous German word in the English language is Beck's.
Beck's, the number one imported German beer.
Holiday Inn.
Welcome to our people pleasing places.
Hi. That the Holiday Inn East, the Holiday Inn West, the Midtown.
The one by United Industries.
The one by the headquarters or the plant?
The headquarters.
We offer you a choice of the most popular locations.
You need three hands.
You're right.
People-pleasing locations.
The airport, the one by Holiday Inn North, or Holiday Inn South.
Is number one in people-pleasing.
I am holding this press conference on my new Panasonic OmniVision home video recorder.
Only Reggie.
For the next 6 hours.
6 hours?
You'll see my greatest plays.
In slow motion.
High speed.
Freeze frame.
And OmniSearch lets you find your favorite part.
Do you believe this?
The end.
Yeah, look who's here!
I wish this wireless remote could control the press.
Panasonic 6-hour OmniVision.
Reggie Vision.
Tonight, on the best of CBS.
Mr. Richard Harper, they tell me you're a man with true grit.
John Wayne, in his Academy Award-winning role. John Wayne, Glenn Campbell, and Kim Darby ride together in True Grit. Next on the best of CBS.
Barbra Streisand, James Taylor, Barry Manilow, Fleetwood Mac, Billy Joel, Radar Weather, Johnny Mathis, Anne Murray, Concise News, Neil Diamond, The Beatles, Clear Traffic Watch, Chuck Mangione, Chicago. Move it easy with clear, continuous music on WCLR 102 FM.
First Pampers invented quilting to help keep babies dry. Now Pampers invents new cushion quilting. It keeps a little baby a lot drier than any Pampers ever did. New cushion quilting. It makes the lining fluffy. Helps keep your baby away from wetness even when he presses down. It's the driest Pampers ever. Introducing new cushion quilted Pampers. Keeps a little baby a lot drier and a lot happier.
Hello and welcome to Asteroids 101, where you'll be learning from experts on the subject. From me, Professor von Busch, and the Atari Video Computer System, 13984 at Toys R Us. Now, should you pass this course, we'll go on to these Atari game cartridges, 1887 to 3697 at Toys R Us. Helmut, I hope you've been paying attention, because I'm going to give a pop quiz later. Could I have some of your seeds?
This diesel engine is what makes the Volkswagen Rabbit and pickup the best mileage 81 car and truck in America. Right now, make your best deal on either one. And Volkswagen of America will mail you a check for the suggested retail price of the diesel engine option. What that really means is you get a diesel at no extra cost. So you can save hundreds of dollars now and hundreds of dollars a year on fuel down the road, if you get to your Volkswagen dealer by December 31st.
One day, little girl, the sadness will leave.